welcome to this week's review of The Kingdom, starring Chris Cooper and Jamie Foxx.
We just learned that 1 hour ago, suicide bombers attacked an American housing compound in Saudi Arabia. The killers wore Saudi police uniforms.
Number so far, 100 plus killed, 200 plus injured.
The FBI would like an evidence response team in Saudi Arabia now.
Your Excellency, Special Agent Fleury of the Federal Bureau of Investigation and his colleagues.
This is not America. Your safety is my primary concern.
I'm going to start this review by saying there have been some great movies made about the wars of the past, like Platoon and the legendary Kubrick film Full Metal Jacket. These were both made well after the Vietnam War had ended. Platoon was released in 1986, and Full Metal Jacket was released in 1987. So that war had been over for well over a decade, and they hardly painted a positive picture of that war. Now, I'm not going to go into all the other movies that were made about the Vietnam War or World War II, because there were a bunch of them. I think this may be one of the few times that I watched a war movie about a current war that we're still fighting in. And I don't watch many of these movies dealing with the current conflicts, only movies dealing with wars of the past like World War I and II and Vietnam. And this really isn't my favorite genre. Now don't get me wrong, there have been some great movies on the subject, but I prefer to watch movies on other subjects in my free time. I think what bothers me most is when I feel like a movie glamorizes war or paints a picture of war that's hardly as dark as it should be. And in my opinion, any movie made about war should be a very dark movie that doesn't promote war as if it's something to look forward to. And I think the beginning of Saving Private Ryan showed how gruesome it really is. And that's how it should be shown, and it should never pull any punches. Some movies feel more like an army recruiting tape as opposed to a feature film. As far as the movie The Kingdom goes, I really did like the very beginning. It gave a nice historical look at our involvement in the Middle East and the Saudi Arabia area specifically. This is a nice setup for the film, and it does work well to set up the situations we're involved with today. Now, one minor complaint is that this movie does move pretty fast and jumps around a lot in the early parts of the movie, and it can be a little tough to follow at times. You're just getting to know the cast, and sometimes the names are just flying by. Now, once the initial onslaught of characters is thinned out, it does get a lot easier to follow now that we're down to just a small group of main characters. The cast is pretty good. Chris Cooper is rock solid as always, and Jamie Foxx can be hit or miss. One minute he's Ray Charles and you're in awe of his performance, and then you see him in Stealth. Enough said. Now, I really wasn't fond of having Jennifer Garner in the film, but I must say she did a decent job. One thing about this movie is that the pacing of the film is very sporadic. It starts out very fast, and then slows down to a limp, and then it goes into hyperaction in the end. Nothing horrible, but the early middle of the film does crawl along, and you do have to wait for the story to kick into second gear. I think the best way to describe this movie is FBI CSI. It's basically an FBI team going to investigate the mass murders committed in Saudi Arabia by the terrorists in the beginning of the movie. Now, I will say the ending was pretty good, and what I mean by that is the last few words of the film were dead on, and they really hit the nail on the head. This is a perfect example of how we can dig ourselves into a very deep hole and we may not be able to get out of it. This war is quickly becoming a conflict that could be a no-win situation for either side. Overall, I would say if you like war movies and you don't mind a film being made about the current war we're in, this will be a fairly satisfying movie, but nowhere near something like Platoon or Full Metal Jacket or even Jarhead. I don't think this movie will have any real lasting effect, but it's not a horrible movie either. If you saw the trailer and thought it looked good, then you should enjoy it. But if the trailer didn't interest you, I'd probably wait to see this one. This is one of those 50-50 movies. About half the people will see it and like it, and the other half won't. For my overall rating, I give The Kingdom 3 stars.
You'll shoot your eye out, kid.
Post your comments below on what you thought of this movie. If you'd like to rate and review a movie, you can do so at www.yourmovieratings.com. At this site, you can upload a video review or even a text review of any movie ever made. If you subscribe to my channel, you'll be notified immediately when my latest movie review is uploaded. Also, if you'd like to see some of the latest info regarding my channel, then check out my website at MrBlacksReviews.com. And if you made a cool video, or you want to share your YouTube channel with other members, then post them in the YouTube section. These forums are dedicated to everything from new movie releases to your very own YouTube channel. And don't forget, I'll be giving away DVDs at the forums, including the following titles: Transformers, Harry Potter, The Simpsons, Hot Fuzz, and 4 DVDs of the movie 300. So join the forums for a chance to win any one of these DVDs. And finally, if you want to see my list of upcoming movie reviews, then just go to my forums and click on the calendar. This has all the movies that I'll be reviewing in the future. Thanks for tuning in, and I'll see you again next week.